In my recent DJI Mini 4 Pro review, I touched upon the height restriction this drone has in the European Union and the non-member states of Liechtenstein, Iceland, Norway, and Switzerland. This is the first drone from DJI not to let the operator override the 120 meter height limit, as long as they accept the disclaimer about obeying local laws. The regulations for flying drones in these countries fall under the European Union Aviation Safety Agency, EASA, and they are rather complicated and can be pretty confusing. This only applies in these countries, doesn't affect the UK yet, and if you live in other countries, check your local laws. But what I'll be talking about in this video is specific to EASA regulated ones and how things are changing from the 1st of January 2024. Surprisingly, DJI have announced that any Mini 4 Pro purchased before the 1st of January 2024 can have its C0 label removed, so the height limit restriction is no longer there. But if bought from the 1st of January onwards, this is not possible. I will go into more detail about how to do this and whether you should in a bit. First, I need to try and explain the operator rules for any DJI drones designed to be flown in the open category, which covers leisure flying and low-risk commercial activities. If I've gotten anything wrong, which is quite possible because it is very complicated, there will be a pinned comment correcting myself. As long as your sub 250 gram drone has either a C0 label on it, was privately built, or it was put on the market before the 1st of January 2024, then you'll still be able to fly it in the A1 open subcategory next year and moving forward. You only need to register yourself in the country you reside in and then stick your operator number on the drone. This is something you need to do for all drones with cameras. There are already restrictions on flying drones over 250 grams without classifications. These are called legacy drones. These become even stricter on the 1st of January 2024. You will only be able to fly these in the A3 open subcategory, and you must take some paid online training and pass the exam. To fly a drone up to 900 grams in the A1 open subcategory, it must have a C1 label, and you also must do the paid online training and exam. Currently, the only DJI drones with the C1 label are the F3, Mavic 3 Classic, and the Mavic 3, the original one. And if yours doesn't have the C1 label on it, you can get it certified through DJI. It's a shame DJI don't offer the same thing for the Superb Air 2S, as I believe it complies with the guidelines for a C1 drone. I guess that's why there's an Air 3. To fly a drone over 900 grams, up to 4 kilograms, it must have a C2 label and complete the relevant training and exam. DJI's C2 drones are currently the Mavic 3 Pro and Inspire 3. This is why the sub 250 gram drone is so desirable. These are the only non-classified drones that you'll still be able to use in the A1 subcategory moving forward, and you don't need to do any training or exams. With the Mini 3 Pro, and now the even better Mini 4 Pro, you can get fantastic footage from them. And prior to these, the video just couldn't compare to the larger DJI drones. The Mini 4 Pro is currently the only sub 250 gram drone that DJI make that has a C0 label on it. There's a little difference to flying your DJI Mini drone with or without a label in that same A1 subcategory, apart from one key difference. If it's got a C0 label on it, then it will have a height lock in the software when flying in EASA airspace of 120 meters, which cannot be overridden. Outside EASA airspace, with the same drone, this lock is no longer there. DJI don't need to, but will be offering a firmware update for unclassified mini drones next month to give them this height lock. They will send you a C0 label if you install it. It's not mandatory, and there is no benefit to you doing it. I can't imagine any new features being added to these drones via firmware anymore, so don't. DJI will be adding C0 labels to all the other mini drones that they still sell. That's the Mini 2 SE, Yeah, they still sell that. The Mini 3 Pro and the Mini 3. They will all have the height lock restriction. So if you want one of these without the lock, then you'll need to buy it this year. All drones sold from January the 1st, 2024 are supposed to have classification labels on them. But there is a caveat which is important for drones over 250 grams, and that's if they are privately built or placed on the market before this date. Then they can still be sold, but they will be legacy drones, so they'll only be able to be flown in the A3 open subcategory, and of course the training and exam, which is what you need to do now anyway. So I expect DJI will continue to sell these until their stock runs out, as they want all their drones to have classifications from 2024. There's already replacements for the Inspire 2 and Mini 3 Pro. I can imagine a more basic Mini 4 being released this year to replace the Mini 3, and a new classified FPV drone to replace the Avata and DJI FPV. Now, going back to the height rule, I want to clear up a few things. This 120 meter rule for operators relate to the distance from the ground. What confuses things are the guidelines for manufacturers, which state the 120 meter height restriction is from the takeoff point. Now, these are two very different things. The kerfuffle we had online about removing the ability to override the 120 meter height limit in the Mini 4 Pro has all to do with people who want to fly in hilly or mountainous areas. If you take off from a valley, for example, the ground level will increase as you go up the hill. But you cannot override this, even though legally you can, the operator rules state, from the ground. The problem is DJI's drones, other than the Enterprise ones, do not have the data telling them the ground height beneath it. They only know the height from the takeoff point. In theory, you could land your Mini 4 Pro higher up the hill and then take off again, as this resets the takeoff height to zero, but that's risky. Unless it's an emergency, I always land right next to me. Even if it had this data, don't forget, if you take off from a higher point and go up to 120 meters, then as soon as you fly back towards yourself, towards the valley, your ground level height will be over that legal limit. So to stick to the rules, you would need to lower the drone. Would you though? Probably not. 120 meters or 400 feet has been standard as long as I've been flying drones, and I've rarely ever needed to go higher. In fact, when I'm needed to fly over higher grounds, I've hiked up there. This brings us onto this offer from DJI for anyone who has already or buys a Mini 4 Pro prior to the 1st of January 2024. That is to declassify the drone. If you own a Mini 4 Pro and think you are going to fly somewhere hilly or mountainous in EASA airspace at some point, even if you don't live there, then you should absolutely go through this procedure to remove the Class 0 label. There is no downside that I can see. The DJI have confirmed to me that it will still get new firmware updates just like the C0 drone. It's a straightforward thing to do. Ensure your controller is online and you have the latest firmware on it and the latest version of the Fly app. Go to the height settings under safety and click on request higher altitude limit, except it's not there for me. So it looks like because I live in the UK and don't have this height restriction, I cannot declassify my drone. And because I often fly in Europe, this is not great. The same for anyone in the world with a Mini 4 Pro who is planning or hoping to fly in Europe at some point after the 1st of January. I've asked DJI if they can make the declassification option available globally for this very reason. Luckily, I am going to France next month, so as long as I remember to bring my Mini 4 Pro with me, I will be able to get it declassified. Anyway, let's get back to what you need to do if you are in a country in EASA airspace. So in the height settings, you will see the request higher altitude limit. Click it and you'll then be shown a QR code. Scan it and it will take you to the application form. Remove the label and take a photo of the bottom of the drone where it was, with it clearly showing the serial number. Upload it, agree, apply, and then go back to height settings. Hopefully it will be removed. And you will now have the ability to set the height to a maximum of 500 meters. You are not able to undo this and go back to Class 0. The DJI blog is confusing in its wording and implies you'll not be able to fly in the open category anymore. This is not the case. You can still fly in the A1 open subcategory with your declassified Mini 4 Pro. It's only if you want to fly higher than 120 meters than you are in the special category where you need to get permission. And that's down to you. If you buy your Mini 4 Pro from the 1st of January onwards, then they will not be offering this declassification. I can see there being a bit of a rush on people buying Mini 4 Pros in Europe and those other countries over the next couple of months, as well as declassified ones being sold for a premium on eBay next year. If you want to buy one, I would be very grateful if you could use the affiliate links in the description, as it really helps this channel. If you own a Mini 3 Pro or other mini drone, there will be a new firmware coming out, which will most likely be in December. And this will put in the height restriction too. And then you can apply for a C0 label to stick on it. You do not need to install this or get a label. There is absolutely no reason at all to do it. It does mean that if there are any new features added in firmware after this date, then you won't be able to install them. But to be honest, the Mini 3 Pro is at the end of its life, and I can't imagine any new features being added anymore. What I could imagine happening is DJI giving Mini 4 Pro owners who buy it after the 1st January 2024 the option to reclassify them. Now, this is pure speculation. What if there was a procedure like the one for the Mavic 3s that were brought in without the C1 label? You could get the Mini 4 Pro height restriction removed and be sent a C1 label to stick on it. This would mean you need to do the paid training and online test to be legal as an operator, though. But it would also let you use the Plus batteries for longer flight time, as the 250 gram weight limit no longer applies, as it's now a C1 drone. But to be honest, if you're going to go through all of that, you may as well just save up a bit more and buy an Air 3, which is C1. It's a superior drone with two cameras, 24mm and 70mm, the same superb OcuSync 4 transmission system, longer battery life, and much better in the wind. It doesn't go any faster due to EASA limits on speed. Well, that is unless you take it over to the USA, where those limits are gone. I think the Air 3 is brilliant. Currently finishing off my big video. Still got a fair bit of work to do on it. And it compares it to the Mini 4 Pro and Mavic 3 Pro. It also features the Action 4, which has shocked me with just how good it is.
Mouthful, you've lost a lot of weight.
A lot of that is down to having D-Log M now in 10-bit, and the wonderful ability to set the sharpness and noise reduction at -2, -2. Something you really must do to get the best looking video out of that, the Mini 3 Pro, Mini 4 Pro, and the Air 3 too. Most of the drones which have it. Because bizarrely, this is still not something the Mavic 3 Pro offers. Oh, and it really needs it. The new Pocket 3 also has this ability. I recently received a review sample, and so far, I'm really impressed with it. This is my mum. Hello, mum. You know I'm following you. Is that your natural hair colour, mum?
Yeah.
How come I am not a redhead?
Well, it's your problem.
Oh. Mum, you look so little.
It's lovely, isn't it?
You look so little. Mini mum. She's 3'5".
Is it much further?
Yes. Hopefully this has cleared things up for you and made you understand the rules a bit better and what DJI are offering. The C0 Mini 4 Pro is still a fantastic drone, even if you can't fly it up a mountain.